every muscle in your body is telling you to keep going, and you just have to think about shutting out absolutely everything. The best and the fastest runs, the ones where you're just kind of a hair out of control. I was studying for the bar exam. I turned on the TV one late night and saw this sport called skeleton, and I've always wanted to go to the Olympics. So I made a deal with myself. If I pass the bar exam, I'm heading to Lake Placid and I'm trying skeleton. 4 years isn't long in skeleton. It's a skill sport, so most people go to the Olympics after 12, 13, 14 years.
The challenges that Morgan is facing as an athlete, I see a lot of similarity to the ones that I face myself. And looking back over where she is now, I recognize how difficult it is.
I realized that if I was going to be the best at this sport, I couldn't be waiting tables 50 hours a week to make ends meet. An athlete had told me, you know, there's this program that allows athletes to train and work and fund their careers while their training being the most important thing. The athlete career program had connections already with corporations and businesses that were willing to work with athletes while they trained. I was looking for the athlete career program to not only give me the ability to put training first, but also to make sure that I was still using the 3 years that I had spent in law school.
Athletes are often the best in the world at what they do, so they have a host of transferable skills that make them top talent in the workplace too. They just have to realize how those skills of time management, resiliency, problem solving can be taken into the corporate world.
Well, you would be pretty sure that if someone is training for the Olympics, that they're going to be dedicated and they're going to be hardworking. There are a lot of qualities you can be certain that they have that will make them good employees.
My job at GE entails working with the Deputy Senior Counsel. I do everything from looking at contracts to letting the human resources managers know the laws, how they've changed, how it will affect their management. The best thing about working for GE and Athlete Career Program is that I can work it around my training. Working from home is key because I can work at night, or I can wait, work at 6 in the morning, or if my coach wants to have the timing eyes out at 7 in the morning or, you know, the middle of the day, I don't have to worry about, oh no, how am I going to juggle my schedule?
Sometimes it's a challenge to get companies to want to hire athletes because they do need that flexible schedule many times. But as soon as we get an athlete into the workplace, just the first one, they realize not only the host of skills an athlete can bring, but also the inspiration that they bring to all the coworkers.
The support network is everything. It's such a crucial part of training and competing. You know, I think back to the support that I had from my family throughout this process. I couldn't have done it without them. And so I think Morgan has that same support system. And in addition to that, now we have each other.
The support system while you're training to the Olympics is something that I don't think you can do without. I'm lucky enough to have a boyfriend who's also an elite athlete. So he kind of knows that we don't do what normal people our age do. And people that you love and care about have to know you've got your eye on the prize, and that's going to the Olympics.
Being able to watch Morgan and see her success and maybe feel like you've had a little part in that is like bringing a little bit of that dream to all of us.
These athletes in particular are really giving up a lot to gain a lot. That's a hard life, and you have to make some tough choices. So I think they're great role models.
I mean, I get scared a lot thinking, what am I doing at my age? But I know I'll be successful at the end because every decision I make, every day, I make it with the end goal of going to the Olympics.